The Owen James Report is brought to you by...
This program is brought to you by the Grace Kennedy Group. We choose to care. Grace Kennedy Money Services has been here for you and your family, here and abroad, because we understand that you're receiving more than money. You're receiving their love. Grace Kennedy Financial Group has been here for you because we know it's more than just investments, insurance, or banking. It's about security and creating a path to realizing your dreams. For 90 years, honesty, integrity, and trust. The Grace Kennedy Group. We choose to care.
Good evening. This is the Owen James Report. In the face of lack of work and regulatory problems, local contractors are calling for a Construction Emergency Employment Program, or CEEP. Yes, you have heard it correctly, CEEP. Contractors and allied industries are hopping mad at what they describe as interminable delays and favoritism in registration and re-registration at the National Contracts Commission. They voiced their grouses at a hastily called but well-attended joint meeting of the Construction Industry Council, the Incorporated Master Builders Association, and the MSME Alliance yesterday afternoon. Vice President of the Master Builders Association, Carvel Stewart, pulled no punches in charging that the impasse is hindering development.
And if we're not developing our people, my view is that we're not developing the country, because one flows from the other. The whole process of educating children and taking them through life is a development process. If it stops when you become adults and now need jobs and you can't get them, then you're not being developed any further.
Sagicor Life Jamaica, which is the majority owner of Pan Caribbean, plans to rebrand Pan Caribbean as a Sagicor entity. The information has already been passed on to the Jamaica Stock Exchange, but not yet published. The OJR understands that Sagicor is to call an extraordinary general meeting of shareholders before year's end to get their vote on the matter. In related news, a senior marketing officer connected to both companies has resigned and changes made in the marketing hierarchy at Sagicor Life Jamaica. We understand that market savvy officer Ingrid Card is to play a more senior role within Sagicor Life Jamaica's marketing entity. On the foreign exchange market, the Jamaican dollar strengthened against the three regularly traded foreign currencies today. In other words, the US and Canadian dollars, as well as the British pound, weakened against the local currency. The greenback closed 3 Jamaican cents lower at an average selling rate of $89.85, whilst the Canadian dollar declined by 48 Jamaican cents to close at $91.57. Sterling fell by 35 Jamaican cents to close at $145.71. Now finally, even as Jamaica grapples with tough decisions to arrive at an accord with the IMF before year's end to unlock much-needed international funds, IMF Chief Christine Lagarde is talking tough to global decision-makers. In a speech today, Lagarde warned that policymakers around the world need to make good on promises and get it right this time by being action-takers and deliver on promises made. Ms. Lagarde told her audience at the Peter G. Peterson Institute for International Economics, this time the world needed a sustained rebound and not a bounce. The Institute is a private American-based non-profit, non-partisan research organization. And that's the Owen James Report. Good evening.
The Owen James Report was brought to you by...
This program was brought to you by the Grace Kennedy Group. We choose to care.